And welcome back once more to China. Live coverage of the Intel Extreme Masters Season 9. Unbelievable. I can't even, mentally can't work out how we've had 9 seasons, other than mathematically, of course, there have been 8 previous ones. Moving on, the semi-finals are upon us, and we are back for our second of those 2 semi-finals. Jim, the hometown favourite against Solar, who has come through as one of the 2 Kesper players that were in the tournament. The other one was Zest, and sort of didn't really live up to expectations, but Solar's done really well.
Yeah.
I think Solar's conquest in the online foreign community has helped prepare him for this tournament. Here we do see the bracket, Jim and Solar, the winner going up to play Tasia in the grand finals.
Yeah, let's start with Jim. Fantastic road so far. I mean, in the group that he had, when I looked at it, I just went, oh, that's tough on Jim. And that's how I looked at it. I literally went, that's hard on Jim. He's got 3 world-class players in his group.
Yep.
And he went, yeah, whatever. And won the group. And knocked out Life out of that group. And knocked out MMA.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, wait, in any tournament, when you look at it, you just go, whoa. How the hell did that happen, you know?
Tasia.
Yeah, no, Jim.
No, I'm saying Jim beat Life and Tasia.
Yes, but he in the group. Life got knocked out and MMA got knocked out.
Oh, yeah,
yes.
You're overall saying who didn't advance.
Yes.
Yeah, okay,
indeed.
Sorry.
Yes.
I misunderstood.
Pay attention, Kev.
It was the accent.
It was the accent, man?
Can you speak in a way that I would understand better?
Oh, okay. I'll speak like this.
Okay,
oh, please don't.
Yeah, no, now I've got it.
Kev and I were on the same wavelength, man.
I'm not part of this.
You need to join in a bit more, otherwise I'm not going to be able to understand you.
No.
Jim, on home territory.
Yep.
And brilliant in the groups. Fantastic yesterday as well. And now faces probably his hardest match of all time.
You know, I would love to see Jim in the final. Just as the tournament goes, to have Jim versus Tasia, especially considering Jim beat Tasia as this lovely gentleman.
Indeed.
Did indeed care to inform me of, because I wasn't here.
Yes, no, nor was I, but I knew that.
Yeah.
Where were you?
I looked at the groups and I was like, oh, okay, I'll just go and cast. And then, but at the same time, it's Solar, man. His ZVP is absolutely ridiculous. So Jim, you're right. This is, personally for me, Jim's true test. This is going to be very difficult.
So wait, Jim beating Tasia in Life, wasn't like a test for you?
I thought that was incredible.
Some of the best PVZ in the world is from Solar. He is sick. He is really, really good, man. What? You're looking at me like weird. It's true.
It's just like, tops a group, beats Life, beats Tasia, but oh no, that was for Kolaris, that was a given for Jim.
Yeah.
This is where he proves himself. I think he's already done a fantastic job in this tournament.
He did pretty good. But Solar is now here to wreck face.
Okay. I'm just gonna put this into some context here, because I think Jim reaching the semi-final is you know, pardon the Rotterdam pun here, it is Jim credible, because we would never have had him down as a top 4 finisher at the Intel Extreme Masters, because not only, other people will say, they'll look at it randomly, they'll go, yeah, well, it's Intel Extreme Masters China, it's the first one of the year, they never have the best players there. Rubbish. The best players in the world have been in this tournament this week.
Yeah.
It's been completely ridiculously stacked, and Jim has stood out like a sore thumb in this, because he's done so well. So okay, he goes out here, he's had a fabulous tournament. But I'm not convinced by the Solar hype train.
Yeah, me
that
neither.
Some people
are
riding.
Oh, damn.
I don't know.
I'm not on this train right now. I'm still at the station waiting for it to pull it. I'm not quite on there.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I said I had to buy a ticket for the gym hype train yesterday.
Indeed.
And I kind of had to after seeing his results, man. Yeah, he did perform well.
Yeah.
But I think also the Solar hype train for me is real. It's real. It's okay. Very real.
Oh, hello. What was that? Oh, premature. Premature handshake. That was.
Oh, okay.
It was okay. I thought there was a refusal, but no, it was fine.
I don't think either of these players are going to be doing any sort of BM.
How we talked about the maps in depth.
We did talk about the maps in depth. Catalina will be our first one.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay.
See, I was paying attention. Were you, James? Obviously not. Obviously not. So, yes, we are moments away.
We got to leave something for the other guys to talk about.
Yeah,
absolutely.
So.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, we've got to leave the other guys something to talk about. So, we're almost there. Samsung Galaxy Solar going head-to-head with IG's very own Jim. IG, of course, currently playing in international right now, so they've got a hell of a weekend.
Yeah, they're doing very well.
Kev's looking at me like, what? Who?
Well,
are we talking about a different game?
I mean, if you seen the results,
man,
by chance?
Dude, wait.
Do you do
people
esports?
Play, there are other games in esports.
Apparently, Kev, yeah. But don't
tell
anyone. I heard there was.
Yeah, don't tell anyone. It's all good. So these two guys just going to get themselves set up, and we will be underway in our second semi-final. I've got to ask you both, are you on board the gym train or are you on board the solar train?
3-2, Jim.
I'm with Kev.
3-1, solar.
Wow, okay. That's a very big difference of opinion here on the couch. Let's find out from our commentary team whether their opinions differ, because there is a Zerg over there who might have something to say about this. Moonglade is with Apollo.
Thank you very much, Red Eye, and welcome here for the second semi-final. Put another shrimp on the barbie, mate, because this is going to be a good one.
Crikey, it's going to be amazing, mate. And, I mean, I going off those guys and their lounge analysis, I'm going to have to agree with James Kolaris and say 3-1 for Solar.
Yeah, I have to agree there as well. I think that what we've casted Solar's Zerg versus Protoss twice already this tournament against
yes.
Liquid Hero. He went 2-0 the first time and 2-0 the second time. Very, very convincing wins. And now Jim is going to have a very difficult time, but I also have to agree with QXC that Jim has proven his worth to be here in the semifinal by defeating Tasia, by defeating Life to top his group in the round of 16 to land himself here. And one thing that we cannot ignore, the home advantage.
Yeah.
The crowd is very much so obviously behind Jim.
Absolutely. I mean, it is a big thing to have everyone behind you cheering your name as you walk on stage, cheering after every win, after every unit you kill. It's an amazing feeling, and I definitely think it'll help him a lot. But you know what? I mean, Solar is so good, and Solar has seen Jim's PVZ before in the groups. He saw him against Life, and it went the distance and went for 3 games.
Mm.
And, you know, judging from what we've seen from Jim so far, he might stick to the same strategy every game. I mean, in that PvP against Sand, he did the same thing 5 games in a row. Will he do the same thing against Zerg? We have to wait and see.
Well, here is the Chinese audience turned up. They were here before, but they've come in numbers now to watch their boy attempt to make it to the grand finals here of the Intel Extreme Masters. Of course, it will be a best of five. Solar, we went to dinner with him last night. He is overconfident.
Oh,
he is
yeah.
so confident for this. He's already thinking about the finals. He's thinking about beating Tasia. He wanted Tasia in the finals, but he's got to get over this hurdle first, and it is a tough one. So here we are, game number one on Catalina. Up here to the top right, or top part of this map, there's the red Protoss player. It's the Chinese home favorite. It's Jim. And you may even be able to hear the noise of the crowd coming through our microphones here in the back. There is a lot of them there. And then down to this left-hand side, as the blue Zerg player from Samsung Khan, it's Solar. All right, Solar, of course, the young 18-year-old from the Samsung Khan, been a pro gamer for about, he's had a pro gamer license for 2 or 3 years. He's been in StarCraft for multiple years. I think he's been in it for 5 years since he was just 13 years old. But Moonglade, talk to us about Catalina here for this matchup and how, you know, patterns, trends occur.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, first off, judging from these positions, Solar's kind of in a disadvantage here because his natural kind of third base he'd want to take, which is above his natural, is the closest kind of base he could take to Jim, which is going to really favor Jim if he wants to do an all-in.
Ooh.
And I mean, one thing we've heard from Solar especially is that Jim loves to do all-ins.
Well,
so he's got to be very careful at this, and we are seeing some cannon aggression from the beginning. So it's going to be, looks like it's going to be a 15 hatch.
And this, if this is effective, this is 100% going to get the crowd rallied up. It's going to get them fully on board the Jim hype train if they're not already. We're about to see a hatch first and a cannon rush, which has not been spotted. The Overlord missed the probe. He's got no idea. He's sending a probe down here. He's already built a couple more, so he's at least at 16 supply spawner pool. He sees the pylon. Now, how good is his cannon defense going to be? Brings down a couple of extra drones here.
Now, the natural is pretty open here. There isn't too much room to, like, make a full cannon block, so we're going to have to wait and see how much Jim is going to commit to this. He does have a lot of minerals, so I definitely think he's going to throw down multiple cannons and try and make these drones work for it.
All right, here we go. Jim, one cannon down. And this is where, one probe gets a lot of damage dealt to it there. And actually, one probe is dead. So that's actually a pretty good start there. But 3 cannons have been planted. And a lot of extra drones coming down from Solar.
Yeah, and I think Solar's actually in complete control of this. He has enough drones down here to cancel every single cannon. And from here, I mean, Jim's going to either have to commit more or he's going to have to expand, put a cannon down at home, and play from behind because he has lost so many minerals now.
Well, he's going to go for it more, Moonglade.
Wow, okay. This is a big move, and he's lost his probe. He's going to have to cancel this and just give up this this aggression here. There's no way it's going to work. Two Zerglings coming, and they're going to clean up the pylons. And from here, Solar is so far ahead. It is not funny, Apollo, not one bit.
I'm not laughing, Moonglade.
No, it's not funny. But, right. You know, maybe Jim has a kind of like a backup plan for this. It's very hard to think of one that's going to be very effective when the Zerg economy is so far ahead.
So in this type of position, if you're solo, I mean, you know you're ahead, obviously, but what are you thinking? What are you planning? How do you play the rest of this out to make sure that you are able to sustain your lead and keep it going?
Well, first off, it is a cannon. It was a cannon rusher. Obviously, it's going to be a Forge Expand. The most natural thing to do is take a gasless third base, and he can do this so comfortably because there is going to be no aggression for the next at least 3 minutes. He is so ahead that he's just going to be pure greed. He's going to get a couple of Zerglings out to stop any sort of maybe cannon rush on the third base, make sure there's no probes on the map to do any sort of shenanigans, and from there, you know, the world is his oyster. This map is his oyster. He can go for any tech. He can drone it where he wants. All he has to do is kind of scout exactly what Jim's plan is.
All right, well, let's find out how Jim can work his way back into this one. He's going to have to find a way to pull himself back. Otherwise, this is going to be an easy one-way road for Solar to take towards victory. Is the Overlord inside the main base now for Solar? Having a look around, he's obviously sees the Chronobush and the probes to get that economy back online. But a big difference when it comes to supply between the both. And then the income's about to rocket ahead for Solar, who's got vision on this natural with that Overlord, having a look at the Zealot being made. And he also has vision of the gases here. So full information, but no pathways chosen yet from Jim. The Cybercore is about to finish up, but look at the way that Solar has vision. You know, on the natural, he's got that Overlord still in the main looking at the Cybercore.
Yep, he has complete idea of exactly what's going on. He's going to see these two assimilators go down. He's going to go, okay, you're going for a tech. You're not going to go for any sort of two gas or one gas sort of all-in off gateway because it's simply going to be too late at this point. Jim is going to have to play defensive for a long time. He's either going to have to tech up and maybe move out slowly, take a third base, or he's going to have to go for a two base timing. But I think either way, it's going to be very difficult. And I think the only, the one advantage Jim may have is that third base below his natural is kind of like, it's got the ramps, it's got these choke points, which will help him out a lot.
Yeah.
So we'll have to wait and see if he's going to utilize that.
All right, well, some of the players that Solar's beaten in the last month or so, top Protoss players include Rain, Paralyze, SOS, Terminator, Deer, and of course Hero twice at this event. He really is on top of his Zerg versus Protoss, as we've been mentioning multiple times here. But we have the tech choice coming in from Jim.
Okay, so it's going to be the very standard sort of Robotech. From here, we also see the plus one attack going down. So I kind of get the impression he will go for that third because there's simply, I feel like it's too late for any sort of timing to work.
Right. Yeah. Well, he spotted it all with this Overlord, just full information. Everything is has got a torch mission on it, unfortunately, here for Jim.
And you know what? Every single base is fully saturated at this point, and he could get there completely without making any sort of aggressive units at all. Only two Zerglings, I believe, on the map. And that's all. It's three queens, two Zerglings. And from here, he can go to any tech on tier two, puts down a Spire, and we'll see what else.
With the freedom that Solar has in this game and the way that he's able to read in the Zergling, sees the probe, the sentries, and Zealot moving over here to the third, he's already at 70 drones. And you know this is a very comfortable position. He's got all six geysers working. He's about to go take his fourth. He's rocketing ahead at this point. Where is Jim's angle here? I mean,
well, it very much looks like Solar is going to go for Mutas straight up. So, I mean, the best kind of advantage Jim would have would be like scout that, go for maybe two Stargate Phoenix and do a hard counter and kind of come back from there, because that's kind of like the only way he's going to get back. And if he hard counters whatever Solar's going to do, it'll give him a window. But from there, I mean, even then, it's going to be so hard.
Yeah, look at all these slow Zerglings moving across the map. As Solar hadn't got Zergling speed until just recently here, and he's going to threaten this third base with just these slow Zerglings. It's going to be a little bit easier than it would have been with Zergling speed, but there's a lot of them here.
He could make something work here. It's going to be so hard.
Adam Mortal is out in the open.
Oh, yeah. But I mean, he's just applying pressure, spending minerals, not any sort of gas, until he gets to Mutalisks.
Has Jim actually got any information in this game about what potentially is going on? All he knows is that the third base has been taken. That's the only scout he's got, the Observer. He's now trying to figure it out, but 10 Mutalisks are already on the way here.
Yeah, this could be checkmate any second. Now, he could even GG out the moment he sees him with his Observer. That's how behind he is. He'll have to warp in Stalkers for defense. No one wants to warp in Stalkers at this time against Mass Muter.
And he spots the Observer, and three Stalkers get warped in, and all of a sudden Jim's like, oh no, this is not how I wanted this to go. That Cannon Rush is meant to work. He's got a third base, sure, but what has he got, as Moonglaze saying, to stop the Mutalisks? There's a lot of them. There's a lot of Zerglings now. Plus one melee is close to being finished up. Zergling speed is close to being finished up. And he can very simply just go into this third. The Stalkers are in the main, expecting the Mutalisks to go straight there. But with the amount of units that Solar has, he has multiple choices of where to attack into.
And a beautiful snipe on the Sentry in the block there. Going to trigger the Photon Overcharge and go into the main where there's only four Stalkers.
Yeah, this looks like it's just game over right here, unfortunately. He's going for the Gateway. He's going to turn some off. The Lings flood in here. And Solar, just with the perfect Cannon Rush defense, has found himself in a leading position for the majority, for all of this game. And he's looking to close this one up nice and easy. GG.
GG.
Very comfortable start here for Solar.
And this is exactly what I was expecting from Solar. Just clean, very precise, and very smart play in his EVP. He is so confident, he is so good at this matchup, that it's actually silly. I wish I could play this well. You know, I'd do very well for myself.
Yes, we would, because that was another Protoss, on a single map that's been just pushed to the side, not even close, as we saw Solo do that versus Liquid Hero before. But Jim now, obviously got a lot of experience. He's placed high in a couple of tournaments in his history. He played in WCG, getting fourth, I think it was. He got fifth in WCS last year as well in the Premier League, and that's a nice high finish. And of course, he's played very, very well here, but he might be meeting his match with Sol up with his excellence in Zerg versus Protoss.
Yeah, I kind of think he needs a bit better planning for maps, because on that map, it didn't really seem like cannons would be a great choice, considering how wide the natural is, how much space there is behind the mineral patch. You'd have to invest so much minerals in blocking off your cannons that if Solar was on top of it, he would stop it every time, and he did.
All right, well, crack another Fosters, mate. It's time to get ready for game number two.
Oh, mate. I'll have to educate you on some Australian beer someday.
4x gold, please, mate. I'll take a schooner.
Schooner of 4x. That's a start. That's a start.
All right. Game two. Or should I say map two between these two players. It's down here in the bottom left-hand side as the red Protoss player here in China. For China. He fights for China. It's Jim. The fans out in numbers. And then up here to the top right as the blue Zerg player. It is, of course, from Samsung Khan, Solar.
So we'll have to wait and see exactly what Solar's going to do this game, considering he had to deal with a Cannon Rush last game. Will Jim do the same thing? I'm kind of thinking no, considering the pylon is in the main. Most likely either a Nexus first or a Gateway Expand. But it's going to be down to Solar to see how greedy he's going to play after something like that.
So, before this game really kicks underway, from my limited experience in Australia,
okay,
there's three words that I can say that warrant an immediate and instant response from any Australian, from what I'm told.
Okay.
And I've never met an Australian who doesn't answer to this call.
All right.
It's like something inside them is automatically triggered. It's like the moon is risen and you turn into a werewolf when I say these three words. Are you ready?
Oh, God.
Are you ready?
All right, all right, all right.
Aussie, Aussie, Aussie!
Oi, oi, oi! I knew that was coming, man. And most of us Aussies don't usually do that. Oh God! When we go to when we see like international events that Australians are at, and we see like the drunk bogans at the top going Aussie, 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 oi, oi, and they're going crazy with their beers and their singlets, we're at home and we're face palming, man.
You're face palming.
Yeah. But it is great to have some patriotism, I guess, and it is our call.
It is your call.
Do you Brits have anything like that?
No, we just say God save the Queen as much as we can.
God save the Queen.
Yep. And she looks after us. She looks after you.
Yeah, I guess she does. Right? I guess we still celebrate her birthday there, and we still have a day off. So I guess it.
Yeah,
I guess so.
That's right. She's your queen too. We share the same queen.
Yeah, how about that?
She's like a great grandmother to us.
Did she? Is she the one that sent us to Australia? You know, in chains?
Not her directly, no. But no. An ancestor, yes. All right, so we have pretty standard openings, I suppose, in recent times here from Jamie. He's just gone for the one gateway expansion. That will be shortly coming down here. He did build a Zealot as well, which is actually breaking down this destructible, whatever that is called, destructible plate or... No, actually, that's just called bricks.
Okay. Is it called bricks?
It's just called bricks.
Oh, I got the Chinese one, so I was going to try to pronounce that. But
it's just bricks. And then from Solo, we do have a faster three hatch, obviously skipping up on a queen there to do so.
That's right. So, you know, Jim can be aggressive on this too, because he did go for gateway, four Nexus, and so three hatchery gasless. You know, it can warrant some gateway pressure, some mothership core pressure. Can even warrant like maybe a four or five gate sort of all in from here. But, you know, Solo will obviously be very experienced in that sort of situation, be ready for it, and will look for pylons. So we'll have to wait and see. It's going to be up to Jim. Jim, also known for kind of being all in-ish in this matchup, so maybe he won't put it past him.
Yeah, well, Solo has just scouted three gateways. Right under his nose there is that Overlord or whatever the Overlord has underneath that. Under his tentacles, or whatever you want to call them.
Snout.
Under his snout.
Yeah.
And so he's obviously knowing that we're going to see a bit of an aggression coming in. And Jim had scouted that third hatchery coming in quite fast. But Solot has got a Zergling in here. It skipped past. The Sentry and Probe will block that from anything. The Chronoboost is into the Cyber Core. Solot sees a lack of second gas. He knows what's happening here.
Oh, yeah.
The question is, does he have the numbers to stop it?
Well, so far, he isn't looking for any sort of pylons. And one pylon is going up very close to his third base, which could cause some trouble. We do see Zerglings being made. We see Zergling speed, which is very important, being made. No Roach Warren or anything like that. So he's just going to rely on his 26 drones, his queens, and Zerglings, which can work. But it's going to be very difficult considering it'll be four Zealots at a time being warped in.
And at this position, do you want to be the Protoss player who moves into attack, or do you want to be the Protoss player who builds up a massive number of Zealots?
You want to build up enough that it's going to surprise the Zerg, and he simply won't have enough. And at this point, he does have enough to kind of deal with all the Zerglings, but more and more are coming out now.
And at the same time, I think this is the beauty of this style from Jim, is that he's consistently building probes behind this while always warping in, whereas the Zerg player, and the way that they work, they're always having to build units and not drones. So we actually see Jim smartly and slowly take an economy lead with this, depending on how this goes, you can see in the production tab.
Yeah, I mean, you can force out so many Zerglings, it completely halts the Zerg economy. And if Jim is trading well, doesn't get everything, doesn't lose everything right away, and has like great fights while probing behind it, he will eventually get ahead in economy.
Yeah, and look, that's a lot of Zealots.
That is so many Zealots.
Also a lot of Lings, though.
Yeah.
And speed seconds away from finishing the mothership. Of course, we talked it down here, and that's not so good. He obviously wants to try to keep that alive. Four Zealots to go towards the Queens to push them back. I mean, he does have Time Warp as well, remember?
The greatest thing here is that he made a drone and built a Spine Crawler behind his third. That is actually such brilliant play. It's really impressive, and it shows how much experience he has dealing with this kind of thing.
Well, Time Warp not really used efficiently there, and here come the wraparound from the Lings. Are they going to be enough in numbers to take down the Zealots? And so far, so good. The Spine getting damage in, the three Queens getting damage in, and it looks like the Zealots slowly but surely are going to get cleaned up here. And Solar makes another good defense, good overall play. Four more Zealots get warped in once again here, but Solar's droning, he's got a lot of Lings left over. He's going to engage into the Zealots. The Queens come down for the Mothership Core, and Jim... Oh, Jimmy boy,
you're in a big trouble, mate. You're going to actually lose everything here. Lose the pylon, almost leave the mothership core. He's going to transition, but for what? He's already down a base. He's got maybe, he's a little bit ahead in worker count, but it's gonna fall behind very quickly from three hatch, three queen.
Yeah, good play from Solo once again. And I mean, let's talk a little bit about Jim's playstyles. This game's going to slow down a little bit. We should see a defense here from Jim against any form of attack from these Zerglings. But how do you rate his kind of playstyle here? It's super aggressive. Cannon
super
rush into
aggressive.
This full gateway.
And I feel like, you know, he's doing it, but he's... Like, Solar knows what to do in every situation. He sees it. He's like, okay, it's going to be this. I'm going to mass Zerglings. I'm going to make a spine. I'm going to put my queens here. And I'm going to wait and continually mass Zerglings until I crush your army. And Jim, he also fought in a horrible position because he was getting hit by the Spine Crawler at the same time.
Yeah.
Very, very big mistake here. So either Jim being very nervous, maybe a little less experienced in dealing with someone of this caliber,
right,
which I think could very well be a thing.
Well, the sentries out here in the open are going to take a fight to these Zerglings. They will win. We need a couple of force fills and mothership core back up. And it looks like Jim is trying to push himself over towards that 30s. trying to get that down warping and a couple of backup units here to support this. But right now, Solov, to be honest, doesn't really give a damn. These are Zerglings from earlier on.
Yeah.
And all he's been doing is droning intensively behind this. He's got the Roach Warren down. He's got the Evolution Chamber coming in. You think he's going to try flood this this third potentially, or is he just going to look to take a fourth of his own to further his economy?
I think he could very well do a Roach timing at this point. His lair is almost finished, so he's going to have Roach speed on the way very, very quickly, maybe even plus one Roaches. He's got full economy. He's getting that fourth of the gold. Got great creep spread to the fourth. I mean, yeah, he could definitely do a Roachling timing, and I think it would work out very well considering the tech of Jim more than anything else.
And even Borrow being researched here, and without a robotics facility, with his playstyle that we see from Jim, and considering that he's behind, it will be delayed for a bit here, you'd imagine, because he just simply can't afford it. He needs all his resources into units. He's going to be trying to get plus two. He's going to try to get Blink. He's going to try to build some Stalkers to get some real damage dealers in this, because currently it's only a few Sentries and Zealots, and they're not going to do well against the flood of units coming in. What information has Jim even gathered in this game? He's very low in the previous game on information. He's very low in this game as well. He saw the Roach Warren a lot earlier on. He's now about to get his third or second scout in, and he sees one lacking gas inside that main. He sees Roaches being built. I think we all know that Jim's like, oh god, here it comes.
Yeah, he knows for sure. It's like, oh great, it's going to be some serious aggression here. Only four gases on three base. Yeah, there's no way he's going muter. He's going for Roach, Ling, and he's going to go for a kill because there's nothing but gateway units at the moment. Sure, he can get some great force fields off. There's going to be Burrow. I don't think we even have a Robotech. We don't. There's no observers on the map. He will Burrow until force fields.
But if he holds it, then he's in a decent position.
Sure, he's in a decent position here. I agree completely. But it's going to be a hard hold, especially with Burrow. Burrow is going to be the key here.
All right, Solar putting the pressure on. The units are being made. He's got that forward hatchery as well. And here comes the first fight from Jim. And pretty good force fields, but as you pointed out, good force fields, but to what end? He can't see anything. They bore it immediately here.
Exactly.
And Jim is pylon blocked at 110 supply. He's capped. He can't add on more units. And he didn't kill anything there.
He didn't kill anything. Not one thing. And from here, it's such an open. He's going to force the units to come out from that choke in the third. And maybe force out more force fields and Burrow again.
Yeah, there's not that much energy left either on these units. A good force field preventing the units from getting into the natural. And Jim holds on for now. Robotics facility on its way. Time warp to slow these units down. Plus two and Blink. Close. He just needs to get up there. He needs that observer in play as well. But this is a lot of units. And every second that ticks by, Solar becomes more of a big, scary monster.
That's right. He's a big monster at this one. He's a... Blimey, he's big. I know we don't use blimey on the device. But yeah, it's going to be a horrible fight. Horrible fight if he goes into this natural here.
The pylon down on the right-hand side. This natural starting to get exposed. Photon overcharges there. Jim still holding on this right-hand flank, but he's running low on energy. Good set of force fields there, but Burrow, again, is activated. There is an observer, though, that is finally in this fight. We can see there's a couple of force fields left. Jim and now has Blink. But look at that. Solo gets right up close because there isn't that much energy left on these sentries. And uh-oh, these units are dying fast. Plus two, not in. And the flood is here. The floodgates are open. And Solar is smashing through. Jim is not holding on. Not holding on. He's still at the same supply while Solar continues to increase. He's about to get Borah movement coming in. He's got plus two attack on the way.
Oh, wow.
Jim needs to hold tight still.
He does. I mean, he does have Blink, and he finally has plus two now, so he can do some damage against these Roaches. But with no force fields and Borah movement speed, it's going to be so hard to trade efficiently.
These Stalkers are getting attacked in. He's lost a lot of the sentries. He's lost all his sentries. There is no way to stop these Roaches from getting up and close and dealing the damage. 182 supply for Solar, and with the income that he has, he's not going to drop down anytime soon unless he misses his lava injects or something. But the caliber that Solar is playing at this tournament, Soul Caliber, is absolutely incredible here. And look at this. This is very difficult. Plus two is done for Jim. He's going to start blinkety-blunking in his way backwards and forward to try to take a good fight, but Solar remains up in supply consistently.
100 supply advantage for Solar at this point. So many Roaches, all in the natural here. They should be dealing with this Robo, but they're going to have to deal with the units first, and as well as, I mean, microing against these Blink Stalkers in the third, which are trapped now.
They are trapped, and there's just flood of units. You just look at the minimap. It is just traditional Zerg swarm, just all the way over. He's broken the natural here. There's no defense. There is no wall. The robotics field is still...
Yeah, that's all there is. That's what the Zerg is saying as they crush his natural and third base at this point. It's only a matter of GGing now. Jim has lost everything at his natural.
And here it comes. GG. Solar goes up 2-0 so fast in the shake of the head. Oh. It's an acknowledgement that he is simply on fire.
He's shaking it off. He's too hot. He's on fire. He's just too hot. It's like, damn, I am so good.
Solar so far came into the group stages 2-0 versus Liquid Hero easily. Got a little bit outclassed by Jadon going down 2-1, but bounced back again versus Hero 2-0. And then, of course, we see him 3-0 versus Innovation yesterday, pushing him aside, and now is up 2-0 already against Jim. Very fast games. And Jim now needs to win 3 games in a row against a player who's playing his best matchup. He's playing on form and is looking unstoppable.
Wow, Spider-Man is even watching. That's how good Solar is. He came to China to watch Solar.
He got a fight from America. He's not saving the streets. Batman took over, and Spider-Hyun is here to watch the absolutely blinding performances from Solar. And unfortunately here for Jim, he's not been able to bring the performances needed in front of his home crowd audience to be able to stop this Kesper player.
So far been very one-sided games. Kind of exactly what we saw against Hero. You know, it's just his style is so good. His understanding is so good. I don't know who you'd bring out to take down Solar with Protoss. It's just insane right now.
All right, we need to see Jim Credible, or Jimba, as Teju was saying, to find a way back into this one. The next map is going to be a Chinese couple of letters, but I'm going to find that out. It's King Sejong Station. A decent-ish map here for Jim to pull this around on.
Not a horrible map indeed, We do see a lot of progress on this map. Very easy to get in a fast third base and defend it quite well. Solar, though, on this map has been playing very, very well, especially with the Zergling aggression that he's been showing.
Here we go, game number 3. Is this going to be a 3-0, or will this somehow turn around? Down here to the bottom right-hand side as the red Protoss player, it's Jim. Superheroes and all cheering for him. Jim Credible sounds like a superhero. And then up here to the top left is the blue Zerg player on a roll. Absolutely amazing performances so far. It's Solar.
Solar, so
good.
With
his double headset swag.
Yeah, that is swagger right there. That is nerd swagger. Ooh. Never mind.
I was just looking at my phone. Not the extractor. All right, do you think the Chinese fans, if Solar was the 3-0 Jim, do you think they would cheer for Solar in the finals?
I hope so.
Or would they cheer against Solar and cheer for Tasia?
Generally, I think the way people will think about this is they're like, you know what, he beat our guy. We want him to win the whole thing, so we'll feel better about it. You know, if the other guy wins after beating Jim, you know, like, it'd probably leave a bit more of a bitter taste in your mouth. Be like, damn it, he wasn't the best player after all, so we don't feel better about it.
Well, I would imagine they would do so. We have Jim, 13 Forge, and immediately, as the drone scouted the probe's location and time, threw down the spawner pole instantly without seeing the Forge. Of course, Solar just on top of knowing where and when that probe will be, depending on where and what it's done before.
Exactly.
And previously in this tournament, Solar's gone in, and if he's seen a Nexus, he's either put a hatchery down or he's gone 3 hatch of his own here, but great reaction from him. Just goes straight over towards the spawning pool straight away.
Yeah, great scouting, and very interesting that we see a pylon go down, though hatchery can still go down where this pylon is not, which is going to be the perfect position to expand.
Oops.
Well, from here, though, Jim might just simply throw down cannons. We'll have to wait and see. Drone's already in position to kind of stop any sort of block, which is very important.
Well, he's got to prevent this wall from being created at the back here that Jim's trying to do. And he's
taking damage.
Oh, he's made a semi-wall. It's not quite finished yet, but he's starting to do so, and it's not fully done here.
It's not fully done.
And another one, and Jim is, as game one is investing so much into this. He's going for it.
He really wants to get this done.
Oh, he's almost made a wall here. Oh, he's dancing around with this probe in and out.
Zerglings are out there. Problems are kind of solved at this point.
And
It's going to fail again.
Jim.
Oh, Jim. Jimothy Jim.
No, Jimmy!
Jimmy down.
Jimmy down. Probe is dead, two pylons, and this is a disastrous start again.
This is an absolute horrible start, and I don't think Jim should have been going for a cannon rush against such a leech hatchery. Obviously, Zerglings will be out very soon, and Solar was completely ready for it. He's like, I didn't even have to like misplace my hatchery. I put it down in the exact position I wanted to. I got my drones down there to cancel it. Zerglings came out in time to clean it up. I'm supply capped. I got my expansion so late. I'm Jim. I'm in trouble.
My name is Jim, and I'm in trouble.
Exactly. He's in big trouble at this point.
And Solar's going to ramp up the pressure even more by getting towards these back rocks. He knows that, well, these are debris. Sorry, not bricks, not rocks. Debris. Not even destructible debris, just debris.
It is debris.
And he knows that Jim's going to have a cannon at the front wall. He sees it with an overlord, I think. So he's going to put the pressure on the back. And Jim actually currently doesn't even see this.
Yeah, and I don't think he would be checking for this either. So, but I mean, it takes so long to get the debris down. So will he get there in time? That was me licking my lips thinking of what the damage could happen. What damage can happen?
The Zerg inside Moonglade is overly joyed of the potential probe death.
Oh, but we do see a pylon go down. We see Jim scattered, so we will cannon this, I believe.
Yeah. Do you think the cannon can get up in time? The debris at half health now. It's close.
It's going to be a close. He could even just chrono out like the mothership core, I think, because the cyber core is almost finished.
Right.
Or it could be just a sentry.
Oh, no, he's actually left the debris alone there. Okay.
Interesting.
Definitely could have put a bit of... Well, he's put pressure on anyway, though. I mean...
Yeah.
Depending on if... He doesn't even build a cannon there.
Yeah, I think he just wanted to deal with the Zealot that came out. He saw it with his Overlord.
He goes back and kills the rocks then.
Yeah, he should. And he will.
Excellent. Solar is just... oh, no, he swings around the left-hand side. Going to have a look towards the front door here. Going to catch a probe, actually.
Yeah.
Which I imagine Jim thought the links would go the other way. But he catches the probe and...
Takes a lot of damage.
Yeah, unfortunately for Jim, this is not the best of series for him.
No, this is just going wrong, worse and worse for him. He's just making the wrong moves. He's not getting them down. He's making bad decisions when it comes to what he sees more than anything else.
Well, he's about to get the first bit of information after the cannon rush failed here. Although he doesn't. No, he actually gets killed just outside the creep, so he's got no information in this game, whether it be an all-in coming from Solo, who doesn't even know if the third is there or not. And to a certain degree, you know, he's gambling on the decisions he makes right now because he's moved the probe down to this third. He's hoping that Solo's got that third in. And if there was an all-in coming, he's simply dead at this point.
Yeah, I think at this point, we might see Jim being quite tilted considering how badly these games have gone for him. He has no vision at all. He's playing blind. And he's like, okay, I guess I'll expand here because I have no idea what you're doing. And it's kind of safe. Usually it's kind of safe. But when you're so far behind an economy, so far behind from like a failed cannon rush, and these five Zerglings have done so much work for Solar alone.
He's picked off another probe there, and Solar does back off with his links. But a fast layer came in, actually. We did see the gases after the gases had been built. The first 100 gases spent onto a layer, and now we're seeing all the other gases being taken. Well, aside from two, sorry, inside the main base. Never mind, they are there as well.
Yeah.
But the Hallucinated Phoenix, more importantly, finally, Jim can get some information. He's got no idea what's going on. And he sees an evolution chamber. He spots the third gas is taken, and you're like, oh, really? And he goes in the main and says, all right, they're building, so that's not as bad as it could have been.
Yeah.
But he sees the layer done. He just doesn't know what that layer's for.
I think he might have a fair idea what it's for. I think he might be, okay, it's going to be one plus Lings and Muters again.
Oh, look at the six gateways in for Jim. What's his probe count? Did he stop probe production? He's at 48. It's not very high here.
Interesting. But he is still making them. He's still making three at a time. So it could be, I think it must be an all-in.
Yeah, it's a lot of gateways, obviously. 8 gateways with the one that's already finished. 9 gateways plus one attack in. Spire has been chosen by Solar, plus one melee on the way, and it is in an awkward location there to the right-hand side, a little bit more difficult for Jim to spot, but an Overseer here trying to get some information. He's going to come around.
Oh, he sees the Chrono gateways. He knows exactly what's going on. That's such a big tell. And from here, I mean, he will just continue to make units. He'll be very careful. He will stop droning. And let's see if he can get out enough Lings or Muters in time, because that is a lot of gateways.
Yeah, and inside the main base, he's even got full confirmation now. He sees the extra gateways being added on. He knows exactly what he's going up against. And from this point on, it's time to build an army, Solar. Two spines are being built. Jim is going to move out with one big fight. The probe is gone, which means no forward pylon. So how are you meant to be aggressive when you have no close reinforcement pylon? There was no probe out on the map already. And Solar is taking Jim for a walk in the park. He's going to get the second probe as well. He finds the pylon, or he doesn't.
He's going to kill Jim instead.
He's just going to go kill Jim. Two forcefuls get planted, and Jim is in a pickle. He moves forward. Does he come back? Does he go forward? There's 30 Mulas coming out. There's a lot of Lings, and Jim is facing elimination right now. Solar is looking at a clean sweep in the playoffs. 3-0 Innovation. 3-0 versus Jim, and he is looking like the true contender to Tasia in the grand finals right now. He's got five spines finishing up. He's hunting down the units. He's ready just to finish this up.
He is so ready. He is just waiting for him to come onto creep, come into the spine crawler range, so his 1+ attack Lings and Mass Muta can crush this tiny gateway army. Sure, he has a lot of force fields. Sure, he's got some stalkers, but I think Solo's got enough.
Yeah, Solo goes straight for the Mothership Core here, or at least he should, and get rid of that, and then prevent the recall. He takes a couple of units down. So far, decent fight for Jim. Lings obviously can't engage into that, but the reinforcement pylon's being taken down one at a time here. That's the only one left, and there's the probe with it too. More and more units getting warped in here for Jim. He's not going to let go of this easy. Five spines. The natural's going to be incredibly difficult to break. Here come the force fields, preventing the Lynx from getting in on the natural. But here comes Solar. He's going to take a fight here. And he goes in for the units. And is this going to be the fight that puts Solar into the grand finals? Jim is dropping into play. That's a lot of Mulas. The Stalkers are getting picked off. The Lynx are breaking through here. Even Drones coming off alive. And if he loses momentum, which he shall do here, it is over. GG 3-0 versus Innovation. 3-0 versus Jim. Wow. So far, this guy is unstoppable in the playoffs.
This guy is insane. He has been playing so well. Another perfect game from Solar. ZVP is his matchup, but you know ZVT isn't far behind, and I think he's pretty happy right now that Jadong didn't win and he doesn't have to deal with another ZVZ.
That's right. He said last night that he didn't want to have to play Jadong in the finals, and he would much rather take on Tasia, and that is going to be an awesome final. Jim has also had a great tournament so far, but unfortunately falls short in the semi-finals. And a little bit of a disappointment for him. Obviously would have loved to have been in the grand finals, but it's Solar who demonstrates his excellence again once in this Zerg versus Protoss. And he continues on a awesome winning streak here at the Intel Extreme Masters. The 18-year-old with near-perfect English from Samsung
so
Khan. His first major performance at an international. He's played a couple before, but this time's his time.
I think so too. He is on fire. He is playing so well. And I'm really looking forward to the finals. It's going to be so good.
It's going to be awesome. So we have our finalists, Solar and Tasia. What a final. What a treat that would be, especially considering that 3-0 versus Innovation. Can he give the same level versus Tasia? We'll have to find out. But before that, Red Eye is on the couch.
Thanks very much, gents. Another very straightforward victory. And you were absolutely right, James. Well, not 100% right.
No.
You were right in terms of the Solar hype train is real. I think we've definitely established that. But you got the score wrong.
Yeah.
How dare you?
I know. I was too generous in the end. Sorry,
3-0
Jim.
Rather than 3. But Kev, extraordinary, really. I don't really know what to say about Jim. He's had a great tournament. Let's just put that into context before we say anything else. But he's played very poorly in this semi-final. And Solar, I don't even feel like Solar got out of second gear, really. I mean, he didn't really show us any special strats. It wasn't anything special. There was Mass Mutas everywhere in game two. Game three was just a mess. I mean, how do you figure that out?
There was a lot more that Solar could have done, even after all of that. I mean, normally what I see from Solar is this kind of like Ling Roach Muta straight up engagement that is horrendously difficult to deal with as a Protoss. That can be very, very scary to deal with just in general. But Jim seemed kind of flustered. Two cannon rushes there, the fun didn't work. He gets trounced in a just Roach pure game in game number two, and then game three tries for the cannon rush again. Jim was, I think, a little bit out of his depth.
The cannon rush in game three seemed ill-fated from its beginning. Solar went pool first. He had a drone there. He saw the pylon building, and he committed to it anyway. It looked like for a moment there, Jim had a little bit of a recovery period when he was making that attack happen at the natural, but there were just so many spine crawlers, so many zerglings, so many mutas, and the economic disadvantage that he had from the beginning of the game really carried through.
How much do you think that helped Solar, having not had to show too much and not really have to play at the top of his game in a semi-final, to now go head-to-head with Tasia?
Well, different matchup, so I mean, I don't think it helps a whole lot. The way in which he played against Innovation is more telling so than anything.
Yeah.
The three builds that he brought to that series are something that Teja is going to be very familiar with. There's no doubt he hasn't played against those before. The Roach Hydra thing is something that catches people off guard a little bit, but aside from that, I think Teja's going to be ready for the solo.
The big thing, though, is that when you 3-0 someone like that in such a decisive way, you are definitely feeling a bit less fatigue. You're going to be more put together, more calm, and just a little less whatever resources are being drained out of your body as you're making those high-level decisions, those incredibly stressful games. You know, that didn't happen for Solar.
Yeah, I mean, it's only 25 past 11 in the morning. We've already done both of our semifinals. And apologies for you guys at home, because I know it's very late in the States right now, and it's very early in Europe, so it doesn't really benefit anyone. So we are going to hold off a little bit before the grand final. We're going to have a little bit of a preview. These gents are going to leave me in just a moment, and when we come back, we will have the winner on the couch. We'll have an interview with Solar. With the magic of television. That's right, we've beamed in Susie and Solar. Solar, well done.
Thank you.
Ears are back.
Yeah.
The victory ears. Yeah. That was pretty easy.
Yeah, easy. It was easy series.
I was hoping you'd say it was a little harder than that, but I mean, why was it so easy? I mean, did you expect it to be easy?
Yeah, I think so.
Really?
Yeah.
You thought it would just be straightforward?
Because he was Protoss, so easy to me.
Really? Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, you're... Yeah,
you're remember, he's one of the top three ZVPs.
Your ZVP is just amazing.
Yes.
But now you have to play a Terran.
Yeah.
So that's going to be hard.
Maybe this leather map will, I think, good for Terran. So it will be hard series.
Yeah, it's going to be much harder. So what was your plan against Jim? What did you think about before you went into the game?
I just want to play safely.
Yeah.
And I can... If I play safely in so I play 15 pool, so I can defense for cannon rush, so I can win easily.
Yeah. Did you expect him to cannon rush?
Yes, I think so. I saw Vuyodi yesterday. Yeah. He loves for cannon rush,
does.
So I prepared about that.
Okay, that was good. What have you thought about playing in the Intel Extreme Masters? How has it been for you? Because we don't see you outside of Korea very often.
이번에 와서 이 경기에 대해서 어떻게 생각하는 이 경기에 대해서 어떻게 생각하는지
maybe very good training for me.
Yeah.
Okay. I always lose that I am online corner first, but this is first time to qualify. So I'm very happy now and I'm really excited about final.
Okay, cool. So I hear that if you win the final, you're going to do something special, right?
I think.
Did you prepare?
I didn't prepare anything.
Right.
So.
But you have to. You've got like 20 minutes, and then you can
maybe
figure something.
Selfie with Apollo.
A selfie with Apollo. Wow. Okay. Yeah. Apollo's just off to the side of the set right now.
Yeah.
Do you like Apollo?
Yes, but he's trouble caster.
He's a trouble caster.
He's a chobo
caster. Oh, a chobo caster.
He's a chobo caster.
Ban him in my game.
Right. What?
Loser.
Loser.
He's a loser as well. Oh, OMG. Apollo has no idea. He's like, what? Why is he chobo?
He's just chobo.
Right. Have you been talking to MC about Apollo?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
No. Just talk with IMC.
Yeah.
Minchuri도 항상 초보라고 얘기하니까.
He's trouble. Just trouble.
He's just trouble.
Okay.
All right. Well,
too
then.
Annoying to me.
Annoying.
Wow. Okay. Is he?
Oh.
Is it? Does he? We're getting assaulted now from the sidelines. Apollo's throwing basketballs, mini ones. Has he as much passion as Tasteless?
열정이.
Yes, I think so.
He does. Okay.
Less than Moonglade or QXC.
Oh, less than Moonglade, though.
Yeah. Less than Moonglade and QXC.
Right. Okay. All right. So what are you going to do if you win Intel Extreme Masters?
With that money?
Yeah, all right. Tell me what you're going to do with the money.
Buy some. Here's many things about animation. And
yeah,
cosplay.
Loads. Yeah.
So some buy for my teammates.
Okay.
And friends.
Yeah.
Some buy for special things for them.
Okay. Okay, that's nice.
You want a ceremony in Hakua? I just asked him, you know, come on, you said you're going to do a ceremony. You're going to do one? He's like, I haven't planned one yet. I haven't planned one yet.
All right, well, we want something out of you, though. You've got to do something big.
Oh, 그래도 하나는 뭐 해야 돼? 우리가 지금 기대하고 있는 중이야.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. And not just ears,
I
either.
I was thinking in the bus.
Okay, all right. You have a think about it. I just wanted to ask you, are we going to see you again outside of Korea? Because it's great to have you at Intel Extreme Masters. Are we going to see some more Samsung Galaxy players playing in Intel Extreme Masters?
Yes.
Yeah. 다음번에 IM도 이제 참여할 건지?
In Canada? If I get a call.
If you qualify.
Maybe that, but I can play in World Championship.
You're already in the World Championship.
Oh, already.
In Katowice. Top two. Top two here.
So 여기서 우승이랑 준우승은 카드비차 꼭 갈 수 있어.
So you're already in.
Yes.
Yes.
You. Yes, I'm very happy.
You're very happy about it. Did you watch it last year?
Yes.
The last season?
For 1,000?
100,000. Yeah, yeah.
SOS. SOS,
envy. Dollar, $0.
Yeah, envy him.
Envy him. Oh, man.
Yeah, he won a lot of money last year. So, well done. Congratulations. And good luck against Tasia.
Yes,
it's going to be a good final.
Yes.
Solar there from Samsung Galaxy, obviously dissing a bit of Apollo, and Apollo might have something to say about that. So we'll go to a quick break. Don't go too far away. The grand final is next.